week, I sat in a very senior RCMP officer's office, and we had a discussion. And in that discussion, he said to me very early in the conversation that drugs are a major problem in the Summerside area, that half or more of the area are affected. I would think that the same thing has happened throughout the rest of the island. I'd like to hear how each of the candidates would address drugs, and it mainly seems to be within the youth and destroying their lives, but I'd like to hear how each candidate would address it from an enforcement, prevention, and a justice point of view.
All right, thank you very much. And to begin the answers, that is a very broad-ranging question, I know, and it's unfortunate, but we have to limit our candidates to 1 minute. But to begin, Olive Craig.
Thanks, Margaret. In terms of, if you remember, a few years ago, the Summerside community came together and they did a community impact study of addictions, and they really felt it was really important to have an in-house treatment program here for substance abuse in adolescents in the province. Unfortunately, right now we only have a day program, so from the treatment perspective, you'd have to look at that. The other part is in terms of, because it's an education forum tonight, a number of students who are having difficulty in school often have issues around self-esteem and confidence. So there are some good programs that are in the school system, are in the community, and also in the school system, from peer education to allergy, and probably expand the program around SAVE, which is a really good program to help kids around violence and bullying, etc., which are some of the factors that leads towards substance abuse. And finally, in terms of with the policing authorities, to make sure that they do the job they're supposed to do and arrest the people that are doing illegal activities.
Thank you. I just want to mention, for the benefit of those who may be in the hallway and missed that question, Margaret was asking about prevention, enforcement, and justice when it comes to the use of illicit drugs on Prince Edward Island. Jamie Fox is next.
I don't know if I know anything about this subject. Education is key in drug enforcement and drug education. But the problem in this province is this. The RCMP run the drug enforcement program. They follow the national program set in Ottawa. The national program in Ottawa does not take into account what happens in PEI. The government of PEI needs to step up with the Attorney General and the RCMP on this island and say, we need street level enforcement. Because right now, I can guarantee you, and nobody can argue this point, we are not doing street level enforcement of drugs to get the pushers and the sellers off. And what that's happening is, it's overcrowding our school system with drugs very openly. The government needs to take a very proactive approach and say, we want street level crime in this province taken care of.
Two-pronged approach. One, we have to increase more education in our school system, but the peer pressure that these students are facing and the availability of drugs, even at the elementary school level, is really scary. A couple of years ago, there was a few extra resources put into a joint drug enforcement at the municipal forces and the RCMP. I'm told that it had significant success. I think we need to put more resources into it. And as Jamie said, I mean, he's the expert on this subject. We need to get more at the attacking at the street level. And if that requires us to work with the RCMP and the municipal forces so that we can do it, that's what has to be done.
Frank McCardle.
Well, the Canadian Criminal Code, of course, is federal legislation. But going back to a point Olive raised, if we keep those fragile people who are susceptible to drugs, those are the people we have to deal with. We see them all the time on the farm when we advertise farm labor. We have these people who never finished high school. They don't have a driver's license. There are a lot more of those people out there. They're very vulnerable to the drug elements. That's where the drug element gets started. We've got to help those individuals. There's a lot of people falling through the cracks there. Those young 18, 19, 20-year-old people. We have to do more. Our system is failing them. I don't know where, but we've got to do more for those people.
Peter Llewellyn. Drugs and education fit very well together. When I was in Newfoundland, I did some work at Cape Whitburn and I closed custody. And that's where teenagers for murder and serious crimes are under close custody. We did literacy programs in there, and 72% of the inmates there, teenagers, had serious literacy problems. Serious literacy problems. 50% of our children right now in PEI in our school system have serious literacy problems. Let's start fixing that. The other thing that I've been involved in my life is the youth center. And if anybody has gone onto my site and seen the video, where we banded together as a community, and in 6 weeks, we created a youth center that was 6,300 square feet. We had pool tables, we had a 50-seat theater, we had dance hall, and we did it all without a single dollar of government money. We did not ask the government for a dollar, and we built it all with volunteers because we brought the communities together. But on top of that, literacy, I'm looking at the light, it's key to the drug problem long term.
Thank you, Ms. Mace. Served the floor is yours. Please speak directly.